It's my true pleasure to introduce our next speaker, who is another champion in the global fight against gastric cancer from another hotbed of gastric cancer. I think it's also red on that map from Chile, South America. Professor Alejandro Covalan is a professor and associate in the Faculty of Medicine of the Pontifical University Catholica of Chile in Santiago, Chile, and he is going to speak to us about the gastric cancer campaign in south of Chile and the social accountability and scientific initiatives.
Well, first of all, thanks, Yuha and Robert, for this kind invitation. As was mentioned before, I'm going to talk about the non-Asian situation of gastric cancer, which is another aspect of this problem. And basically, our approach is not a research approach, fundamental research, but trying to solve a situation in my country about the waiting list. And in this scenario, we're trying to hook up with research initiatives. So I will start, this will be the outline of my presentation, gastric cancer in Chile, cancer burden initiatives that has been developed in Chile, the social accountability problems, which is the endoscopic waiting list, and the campaigns that has been developed by the group of gastroenterologists, and scientific initiatives that has been implemented along with these campaigns in order to understand and try to solve the situation that is the common topic here. First of all, Chile is a very special country because, as you see here, it's a ribbon-shaped country, very long and very narrow at the same time. It's not a highly populated country, 17.4 million people, and not very dense in terms of population, and has a extreme varied geographic and climate situation with the desert in the north and glaciers and lakes in the south. Ethnicity is mostly people from European and Indian ancestry. And our expectancy of life is quite good, similar to developed countries. Even though we are not a healthy population because we have a high salt intake, a lot of sedentarism, high cholesterol, overweight, and smoking are common things in my population. Maybe that's why we mostly Chilean dies by cancer, 24%, or cardiovascular diseases. And I highlight this cartoon because I work in a center that's called Advanced Center of Chronic Disease, which is a 10-year joint effort between the top one university in my country, University of Chile, which is a public university, and Pontificia Universidad Católica, which is my institution. So we're trying to tackle cancer and cardiovascular disease because they together represent 50% of the mortality in my country. Focusing on gastric cancer, 36,000 people is diagnosed every year in the country. 22,000 of them will die eventually of gastric cancer. And the age standardized incidence is 17.6 per 100,000 population per year. And I think this is important that 20% of population get gastric cancer before age of 75. And as I'm showing here, gastric cancer, which is the focus of this talk, is number one in males. And in females, ranks third after gallbladder carcinoma, which is a unique situation in Chile, and breast cancer, which is a common tumor in females. But I would like to highlight that gastric cancer is really important problem in Chile. Not only Chile, if we look for the region, Guatemala is number one in the region, followed by Ecuador, and we rank third. And what I think is striking here is quite interesting that the gastric cancer problem in South America is the Pacific side. As you see here, most of the numbers, high numbers, are in the Pacific side and not in the Atlantic side. So basically, our continent, our region, divided by the Andes Mountains, which is around here, into basically two situations in terms of gastric cancer. And we're talking about the Pacific side situation. And South America represents like 20% of the gastric cancer burden in the world, ranks third after Asia and Eastern Europe. So for us, this is a big problem locally in Chile, but also in the region. We have a population-based cancer registry in the country, which represents roughly 20% of the population. And this is important because when we look at the situation of gastric cancer in my country, and we compare the north, which is called, for example, here, this register that's called Antofagasta, mortality this is incidence. Incidence is quite different than the south, even though it's important numbers. But Valdivia in the south here is close to twice to the north. So basically in Chile, gastric cancer problem can be divided between the north and the south of the country. And for females, it's the same thing, 15.5 in the south and 8.8 in the north. Still high numbers, but clearly the problem of gastric cancer in Chile is in the south and not in the north. And maybe this is related because we have totally different geographic conditions. Another important issue in terms of gastric cancer in the country is that this situation has been present for the previous 3 years, and eventually it will not change. This is a projection for 2013, and as you can see here, at least for men, for males, it will not change nothing if we not do something. So that's why it's important. This is a real important situation in my country. That's why there's a lot of cancer initiatives, not only gastric cancer, but gastric cancer is the main one, run by Minister of Health, by academia, Catholic University and University of Chile, which is my center that act this, medical societies, which is the driver force in the campaigns, and cancer-oriented hospitals, research institutes, advocacy groups, and also agencies that support research. These are some of the examples of these gastric cancer initiatives. This is a local project that we have in Santiago, the capital, Prevecan, who's run by Dr. Riquelme, 100 patients, gastric cancer month, by Carlos Barriento in a cancer-oriented hospital, which is a Fundación Arturo López Pérez. And then Mid-South in the Maule, and our initiatives, 160 patients, by far the most successful and more impact in terms of cancer initiative has been these campaigns in the South, with close to 4,000 patients has been endoscoped in between 2016 and 2019 in several places in the South. So I will focus about the campaigns in the South. And why the campaigns? Because there's a waiting list problem in Chile that has been in the media. This is a Chilean newspaper that's published in English. And health waiting list in Chile, a matter of life and death, which is a quite dramatic title. But also in the medical literature has been published. This is a publication that has been recently published by a group of Chileans and Johns Hopkins researchers, that this prolonged waiting list is associated with increase of mortality. And also there are some governmental initiatives like Compromiso País, which means country commitment that nobody stays behind, and then that highlight that clinical management is a big cause of this waiting list problem, and basically because we don't have enough specialists, gastroenterologists, and also we don't have enough resources to have enough numbers of equipments to perform these endoscopies. So 50% of the problem is a clinical management situation. So in this scenario, Dr. Robinson Gonzalez, who between 2015 and 2017 was the chair of the association, the Chilean Association of Digestive Endoscopy, put the proposed to perform these campaigns in the south of Chile, basically in these places that I highlighted here, Curanilahue, Victoria, Nueva Imperial, Pirufquén, because they have a long waiting list that span for at least 4 years. People can wait for endoscopy. So he is the one who, along with another group of endoscopists, volunteered to perform these campaigns. But it was not just to do the campaign. They first has produced recommendations by the Chilean Association of Gastroenterologists to how to manage these premalignant lesions. This was published in a local journal in Chile. And they proposed a systematic screening protocol that take at least 8 minutes between the procedure for intubation and there's several kind of photo documentation. So there's standards in the endoscopy procedure. This has been recently expanded in an international group of specialists that published last year this guidelines for photo documentation. And in addition, all the endoscopic examination use the Sydney sample scheme for OLGA and OLGIM standard or staging in terms of identify the risk of the patients for developing gastric cancer. And this is a publication by Ruch and last year that in some way proved that a high risk OLGA staging, which is 3 and 4, has a risk of 36 to 63.1 per 1,000 people a year of developing gastric cancer. So high risk OLGA is a risk condition for developing gastric cancer. So the second step was to perform the campaigns, which was driven by the Chilean Association for Endoscopy, by Dr. Gonzalez and his group for volunteering endoscopists. But also they have to organize these activities with the Ministry of Health, non-profit organization for logistics, and companies or medical equipment companies who donate the instrument to perform these campaigns. And also my role here was to organize scientific initiatives, initially by my own projects and then with NIH and European Union research proposal that is an ongoing activity right now. And the focus was Nueva Imperial, which is, as I mentioned, they have at least 4 years of waiting list in that city. This is Nueva Imperial. This is a very nice city. They have two rivers here. It's a very Indian or native people populated. And as I said, it has a waiting list. And they have a good hospital with enough resources to set up the campaign, which is another issue that sometimes we find places where they have a long waiting list, but in a very in a very old hospitals that they're not allowed to, you know, to this kind of set up all the equipment necessary for the campaign. So in that year, 2016, we performed, I said we performed because I feel part of the campaign, even I am not endoscopy, I just do research, but I've been very pushing this effort. So we performed 750 endoscopies and we articulate scientific initiatives, and basically that was a very simple campaign in which we took a blood sample in 250 patients that were able to to donate the blood sample. And with that, we explore cell-free DNA, which is a biomarker that we published several years ago that's called Repimo, and we have not very encouraging data. Using Olgim as a standard, we have very weak data, so now we're trying to develop more sensitive methods. So the next year, 2017 and 2018, for the next 2 years, the campaign was expanded to more than 1,000 patients each year. And we hook up with an international project, NIH project that is cancer precursor lesions, run by Christian Avnet and Constanza Camargo, who are in the room here. And that was a very demanding protocol because it's not only blood sample, but also urine, fecal samples, and a long interview. But also we have a standards in terms of pathology with a second lecture by a local pathologist, Tomás Ceballo, and Maria Blanca Piazuelo, who's also in the room here. So we, in some way, we have like a really international and very demanding protocol that was, as I said, together with the campaigns. And this was for 2 years. And these are some preliminary results from 2017, almost 1,000 patients. And what is important here that for intestinal metaplasia, we have up to 41% of the patients, which is a really relevant numbers, which we believe that is the real focus of this, all the efforts. We are not very successful in terms of getting gastric cancer, but as I said before, this the purpose of these campaigns is to solve a waiting list for the people that for this community. And in that year, 2017, in 896 patients, we performed pepsinogens, and these are preliminary data that we have odds ratio as a standard one for atrophic gastritis, and in the antrum, the intestinal metaplasia correlate with pepsinogen with an odds ratio of 1.71. But if we extend to the body, this goes up to 9.61. So it's, I think it's very encouraging data that pepsinogen has a role in identifying high-risk patients. For the next two campaigns, to 2020 and 2021, we are going to work with a European group focusing on breath volatile organic compounds. This is called BOGAS. And here I want to highlight one specific scenario that we also developed. This is outside the campaign. It's in Villarrica, which is, if you maybe here, this is a lake here, which is shown here. This is Lake Villarrica. This is a Villarrica town. And the Villarrica town has a very old hospital, which is here. It's more than 50 or 60 years old. And there are a lot of containers here. That has been the strategy for the hospital to expand new facilities. And this one here is our research unit that we established a year ago, which is this container here. So if we take a look inside, we have a minus 80 centrifuge, a place to interview people and also to analyze the samples and other facilities. So we were able to install a research unit in a hospital that was not any capacity to perform research. And this was an initiative led by Dr. Luis Copelli, who is another fantastic gastroenterologist in Chile. And in this case, we are recall patients with previous diagnosis of intestinal metaplasia, because I think, as I mentioned previous speakers, the key thing for intestinal metaplasia is to follow up those patients and to have samples for future research. So far, we have a 90% participation, 100% of recruited patients, and we have identified one early stage gastric cancer and one high-grade dysplasia in this initial initiative. So this is in some way outside campaigns, but it's another effort in which we set up a research unit in a hospital that was not able to do research previously. So to finalize, I think this gastric cancer waiting list has been a kind of organization between different entities in which we impact the waiting list because nowadays from 4 years now it's a 6 month waiting list. So that's why we keep doing campaigns every year. Patients with H. pylori were treated and also evaluation by antigen stool test was implemented, and we were able to organize not only gastroenterologists but also other advocacy and companies that donate equipments. In addition, this is important because 1/3 of all Chilean gastroenterologists volunteer 2 days for free to perform these campaigns, so it has been very exciting activity. Now we have a second waiting list because there's many more gastroenterologists who are willing to participate in the campaigns. So we have an also waiting list for gastroenterologists to participate. There are international endoscopists who also visit us from Japan, Korea, and United Kingdom. And we establish an annual workshop for pre-neoplastic lesions, an online platform to share and discuss pre-neoplastic and gastric cancer cases, and an annual award to promote quality for endoscopic procedures. And as I mentioned, we articulate national and international projects. So with that, these are some pictures, people maybe you know here, Cristian Net, Constanza Camargo, myself, this is Dr. Robinson Gonzalez, this is Dr. Luis Copelli, this is Villarrica Lake, it's an amazing place to visit. These are pathologists, and this is a classical picture, this is Maria Blanca Piazuelo, Cristian Net, Constanza Camargo. It's a classical picture that when you get to the place, you take a picture in front of the airport. And this is a farewell campaign in a what's called Ruca, which is a place of the in native people who lives in this region. And this is the research group that participate in the campaigns. Thank you very much.